Everyone, welcome to round three. We have won the roll again, and so we're gonna play first. Let's see what we have. Sand is kind of bad. We don't have any plays until turn four, so I'm gonna mulligan. This hand is not great, but I don't want to mulligan five, so we'll go ahead and keep this and start off with adventuring gear. Probably gonna lose just because we don't have any creatures. So we might have to use our removal on creatures that we wouldn't or not, that we would not normally like to do. And so we probably want to save the Tomb Hex for a Living Tsunami, because we passed one of those. And we'll go ahead and just play this Swamp. Auto yield to this, F6, and there we go. Colossal Hireborn. Yeah, we can go ahead and smother that. That's fine. Die! As much as I don't want to spew off removal, that's going to do a lot of damage to us. And so I'd rather just get a creature. Sejiri Step. Yeah, I think we can probably just hold on to our lands right now. Because they are going to equate the damage. And we do have a bunch of staplings. So, and this is going to be something that we can use later on. So we'll just have to wait and see. Mindless Null. Yeah, that's fine. You can definitely have that. Creature? Ah, Marsh Threader. Well, that's certainly worth keeping around. Going to hold our land still. The tightest of plays. I wonder if he has the Urge to Feed. There are a lot of black drafters at this table. I mean, we were drafting black, and then we played against two other people who were drafting black. So what we're going to do is going to go ahead and equip. And let's see if we get the chance. Walking Atlas. Yeah, sure. Okay. So let's go ahead and equip. Bam. You want to let that happen? Looks like you do. So let's go ahead and play our planes. Are you fine with that? How about four damage? What do you think about that one? A little less. Yeah, there we go. Nom nom nom. Unfortunately, we do not have anything that can stop that. So we'll go ahead and ship the turn. Take some more damage. All right. So we're taking three, down to 15. And I can only imagine that we may get Mind Sludged by that Mind Sludged creature, the one that costs three and has a multi-kicker. That's going to suck. Ooh, a Stepling, so that's good. So we're going to go ahead and try this again. Unfortunately, we're at the point to where we're going to start. We're going to start falling behind because we're racing 4-3, and so that's bad. Looks like we may be playing against Mono Black, actually. Nothing, huh? All right. Let's see. What are we going to do? And we can let's see. Does this gain protection from the color? Yeah, so that doesn't protect there. So what I'm going to do is play. I'm just going to play the Swamp. Auto yield to my Steplings. And smash. That's more like it. Then we can play another one of these. Mindless Null and Walking Atlas. Not my favorite of creatures. Although I suppose we should have moved the adventuring gear over to the Marsh Threader. That would have been better. Just because that's guaranteed damage. Oh well. Our play next turn is not going to be. I don't think it'll be affected too much by it. And a grappling hook. Well, that is going to sort of blow him out. Let's go ahead and move. Let's see. I'm gonna keep the adventuring gear over here for now, just because I want to have the marsh threader around in case he has removal. So let's hit for another 5. I can only imagine that he's gonna spend his turn using the hook on his null. So let's go ahead and move over our marsh or adventuring gear now, since he's probably gonna hold back with the walking atlas. Creature has a double strike. Whenever a equipped creature attacks, you may have target creature block it this turn if able. Well, mine this null can't block. And none of our creatures can block because they're tapped. And I can only hope that he does not have spell pierce. Get over here! Sorry. I do not wish to take 4 damage. Do you have spell pierce? Because that would suck. Moderately. No, you don't. Excellent. Spell pierce was actually not really played as much as it should have been, I think. And there's the island, so he does not have living tsunami in his hand. Paralyzing grasp. Okay. That is fine. We have Sejiri's step. So what we're going to do is we're going to move the adventuring gear over here to our step links. Play Sejiri's step, triggering landfall a bunch of times, giving our Marsh Threader Pro blue. Dink. Oh, look at that. Then smashing for 4. We're not quite there yet with the damage. And no blocks. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and move this adventure gear back over. And then we can shift the turn. So I think we're doing reasonably well. We'll just have to wait and see what he has for us in store for us this turn. And it doesn't look like anything. Looks like he's just going to get attacked for 2. Sure. Fortunately for us, the equipment does not untap the creature. Then it would be a lot better. As it is, I think it's moderately unplayable, just because 4/4 is so much. Oh, what's this? Vampire's Bite. Okay. So we're at 1. Kind of sucks. Yeah, that kind of really sucks. We're just going to have to bash and then exile his creature. Jeez, Vampire's Bite. I guess we should have waited with Tomb Hex until after he had used his Vampire's Bite, if he didn't indeed have that. Okay, so this game's gotten a little bit more interesting. I guess we're going to have to be dead to a flyer, I suppose. Hedron Scrabbler. Yep. I'd like to draw something nice. What would be nice? We could draw a core outfielder. Yeah. Battle Herda will also do it. So I wonder if he has removal. I sure hope not. All right. So we're gonna smash, play land. So this means that he'll be dead if he doesn't have anything. I think this is the point that we should be at. Is he blocking? No blocks. All right, hope you don't have anything. And here it is. We're blocking 100%. If he'll let us. Could have something like Whiplash Trap. Okie dokie. Marsh Casualties would suck. Four. Another's Vampire's Bite? Sure. I'm fine with that. Not really, but you know. Hag or Crocodile? Okay. So Landfall, we're in trouble. So seven. Plains, does that do it? 2, 4, 6? No, not quite. Alright. I'm gonna have to attack again for 6. Hope he doesn't have anything again. If we draw land, we're good. If we draw pretty much anything. Alright, here it goes. He is double striking. And we are most definitely blocking. He's gotten a lot of Vampire's Bites. And Nimbus Swings, that also does it. A Flying Swampwalker! Oh wait, no, we can't play this as... Oh no! I thought you could play it as an instant. Ugh. Alright, we actually... Yeah, that was terrible. Well, we won that game. Alright, so that was awful. I'm going to go ahead and bring in this Bog Tatters and sideboard out of Nimbus Wings.